All right, we're back, Bo and Jamie. Not far from opening kickoff time. Quickly, the offensive starters for Honaker, Peyton Music, will be at quarterback. Parker Bandy, Avery Music, and Jax Dye will be wide receivers, and Malachi Lowe is the tight end. Aiden Lowe, and I can't brag on him enough, Merle. We were up there against Ernie and I were up there watching him play Patrick Henry last year, and he scored 8 touchdowns.
Yeah, he's a good running back, and
that's probably a record around.
Even a better boy. I've met him a time or two, and he's an outstanding young man.
Yeah, he's a good kid. At one tackle, we've got Elijah Music. Aiden Gilbert is at guard. The center is Maddox Sykes. Jacob Powers is the right guard, and Tyler Cole is the right tackle. That's your offensive starting lineup for the Honaker Tigers. All right, we'll be back with more. You're listening to High School Football on WXLZ. Got another piece of newspaper. Sit down there underneath you.
Maybe.
I don't know what I've done with it.
Some in here.
Yeah, that's what I want.
You can take another minute or so, Madison.
Go ahead, she can hear you.
We're going to do the national anthem now, so it'll be a couple of minutes yet.
Thank you.
All right, we've had the national anthem. Both teams getting ready to come back on the field. Murray, you got those officials, I think.
Yeah, the officials for tonight's game. The referee is Chris Davis. The umpire is Brad Christian. The linesman is Cecil Coleman. The line judge is John Campbell. And the back judge is a familiar name to many of us, Johnny Poole.
Johnny could walk to work here tonight, couldn't he, Merle?
Yeah.
Both captains out there. For both teams.
I guess you mean by Johnny working a lot, they're going to throw the ball a lot.
Yeah.
He's the back judge. He'll be in the defensive backfield.
Max Boyd, one captain for the Pioneers, Carterville, and another. Dusty Rose, another captain for the Pioneers. And Caleb Simmons. For Honaker, we've got Peyton Music. He's one. Carter Bandy, I think's one. I'm not sure who we got here. This wind's killing us, Merle.
Yeah,
blowing our papers everywhere.
A little trouble with the wind, but maybe it'll lay down here. The teams are meeting in the middle of the field for the flip of the coin to get things started. Chris Davis, the referee out there. Four players out there for each team. Caleb Simmons is one of the Lebanon players out there, along with Carter Dillon is out there, along with we don't have the number on one of them. 50, is that 59, Jamie? It must be Isaac Oliveira.
Yeah, that's who it is. Pioneers won the toss and they deferred. Honaker chose to keep the ball, and the Pioneers are going to kick off. Lebanon look like going to defend the east goal. Honaker will defend the west goal.
We're trying to pick up on some of these players.
Not much wind blowing down on the field. The flag's hanging limp, but it's blowing through this press box pretty heavily.
We'll do the best we can with the wind blowing our papers around here with the rosters on it, and we're not used to these rosters yet either, so Honaker's got a big smoke bomb out there on the field to run through as they come out, and here they come onto the field. Honaker dressed all in white with orange numbers and black helmets. Lebanon trotting out onto the field now. They'd already made their big entrance.
Yeah, Pioneer's been out there.
Getting set to kick off. Looks like Carter Dillon will do the honors for the kickoff.
Yeah, I think Carter's been kicking that ball pretty well.
Kicking extra points and so on, too.
He was kicking, looked like to me, about a 40-yard field goal in the warm-up time.
You know, the wind's whipping through here on us, but the flag over there on the far corner is not moving.
No, it's limp, so evidently this wind's just a little bit breeze up here higher.
See if we can tell who Honaker's got back, Jamie.
Well, I'll see if I can pick up a number.
Not a very good view through the window here. Number 3 is one of them. That's Avery Music.
12 looks like the other deep man.
The other one is 12, would be Aiden Lowe. So Avery Music and Aiden Lowe back there to receive Carter Dillon's kickoff, and we're just about ready for that to happen. There's the whistle. Dillon kicks it short down the sideline. It's going to be taken by one of the up men for Honaker. He's dropped at the 40-yard line. And that was Parker Bandy on the receiving end of that kick. Honaker will have the ball first and 10 from their own 40-yard line. Spotting it down. They haven't put the ball down yet, but they're spotting it right on the 40. I don't know why the umpire or the referee is not putting the ball down. Now he puts it down. The ball's on the left hash mark. Honaker going west to east. And they come out with two wide outs to the right, two wide outs to the left. The quarterback is Peyton Music back in the shotgun with the running back. Can't see the number.
That should be low.
And there's a whistle. Somebody jumped. I think Lebanon moved. That'll give Honaker 5 yards. They're going to mark it up to the 45. So it's first and five for Honaker from their own 45-yard line. Can't tell if that's low or not in the backfield.
That's number five.
It's Jason Jackson Dye in the backfield. And they fake to him. Now they're going to throw it deep down the right side. They got a man open. And he's going to score on the first play from scrimmage for Honaker.
45 yards.
I think it was Parker Bandy on the reception.
Number four.
That's Parker Bandy. So Honaker goes up 6-0, and now the try for extra point. Quarterback over there on the left side of Lebanon's defense just got burned.
He did.
He came up too far, and Bandy ran right by him, and Music laid it out there for him. Looks like Honaker's going to, are they going to kick it? Or?
Looks like they're going for two.
I think they're going for two. Spread out with wide outs, two to both each side, and a wing back in there. In the shotgun, Music takes a snap and rolls out to the right. He's going to run it, and he's going to make it into the end zone for the extra point. Two-point conversion. Honaker goes on top, 8-0, 48 to go in the first period. We'll be back in a moment. You're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ. Honaker kicks off after the touchdown, and Lebanon bobbles the punt. Now back there, picking it up and running it out to about the 12 or 13-yard line. Couldn't see who that was, Jamie. They bobbled it back there. It was a short kick. Bobbled it, and it went back near the 10-yard line, so right. Pioneers got their back to the wall now.
They're at their own 12-yard line, where it will be first and 10. So Honaker scores on their first play from scrimmage. The Pioneers getting ready to run their first play from scrimmage.
Pioneers are spread out, too. They've got two wide outs left, two wide outs to the right. Running back is Dylan.
Got a man in slot also.
Handoff is to Dylan. In the middle, not much there. I'm going to say about a 2 yard gain. Puts the ball on the, looks like it's on about the 13 or 14 yard line.
Same set, looks like.
At least second and eight now. Dillon goes in motion, throw over the middle is complete. And up the middle goes the receiver. He fumbles it. And it looked like Honaker fell on it. That was...
I think a ground caused that fumble, but no, it's going to be a turnover. I'm not sure who caught it.
I think it was Justin Taylor that caught it. And when he got tackled, he lost it going to the ground. I thought it came up, came out before he hit the ground. Honaker's got it. And that's the call. So a lot of turnovers in that game last year, Jamie.
And pick up 31 yards on that play.
Got it up to the Lebanon 45, and Honaker will have it there now. First and 10. They send a little confusion there. Lowe stays in the backfield. They send three wideouts to the right, one to the left, and Music in the shotgun. He throws it quick out to the right side and dodging one tackler and going down to the Pioneer, about the 35-yard line. Going to mark it right on the 35. It'll be first and 10, Honaker. Who'd you have on that reception, Jamie?
I think Lowe caught the pass, to tell you the truth.
I think Lowe went in motion. I think it was that wide out on the far side that just stood right where he was and caught that and then ran upfield. Here's the first down play. Now they hand it to Lowe right up the middle. He breaks a tackle, runs over a couple of players all the way down to the near the 20-yard line. It'll be another first down for the Tigers. First and 10, Honaker from the 11.
Mark him on the 19th, Merle.
On the 19-yard line. Honaker threatening again. Honaker leads it 8-0 if you just joined us. Honaker scored on their first play from scrimmage on a long pass to Bandy. Now here's Music in the backfield, dodging players and getting away, running it out on the right side, down inside the 10 and maybe inside the 5 before they knock him out of bounds.
Yeah, he got it down to about the 2 or 3 yard line. I believe he's going to mark it on the 4. So it'll be first and goal for Honaker from the Pioneer 4-yard line.
Carter Dillon ran him out of bounds down there. Got a timeout. Timeout on the field, Tigers. We'll take a break with them. You're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ. Still got wideouts on both sides. And Lowe is the back with Music. Lowe and Music both can run the ball really well. Here's the first down play. Music back to pass. Throw it out in the flat on the left side, and it's complete for the extra for the touchdown. Didn't catch who caught that. I can't see down in that corner, Jim.
I can't either.
Just gonna have to listen to the PA man. Try to get that receiver's name here in a minute. Honaker looks like they're going to go for two again. Honaker's leading now 14-0 with 9:37 left in the first period. Man in motion from the left side. Music thrown over the middle and it's dropped. No good. So our score is Honaker 14, 11-0. We'll be back. You're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ. Honaker kicks off again. It's taken about the 12-yard line. Run to the left, getting around the left side, and finally knocked out of bounds out about the 25 and 30. We'll see where the mark at. Lebanon will have it first and 10 for their second possession.
Looks like about the 27 is where they've got it laying over there.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
Seth Smith on the return of the punt, of the kickoff. The Pioneers will have it now. They send three wideouts to the right, one to the left, and Reese in the shotgun. Takes a snap, throws a quick out to the running back, and he goes all the way down almost to the marker for the first down and see if he got it. And that wasn't Dylan, I don't believe, was it?
23, it looks like.
That was Dylan. Was Dylan. Carter Dillon with the reception.
Picked up, 9 yards?
Looks like official timeout. They're trying to decide over on the far sideline. It looks like maybe somebody got hurt over there. Somebody over there right at the, where the tackle was made out of bounds. I can't see if they're working on the chain or if somebody's hurt, Jamie.
I can't see either. I don't know.
Can't see it.
Yeah, he got a first down, looks like. No.
Maybe he stepped out of bounds back there. He knocked that marker off at the first down, at the point where he would have had a first down, but they're moving it back. Putting the ball about the 27. No, it's not the 27. It's at about the 33-yard line. Rex is slow on the scoreboard down there.
They must have stepped out of bounds over there because they're going to mark it on about the, look like about the 32-yard line.
I don't know what's wrong. I guess there's something wrong with the chains, what they're working on over. Now they appear ready to go. So Lebanon will have it now, second and four. On the 32. Wideouts, two on each side. Hand off up the middle.
Ball and comes loose again, I think.
I think Lebanon recovered it. Ball came free again in the middle of the pile up there. Peyton Gilbert recovering. It was Dylan that fumbled that, I think. So it'll be third down and four for Lebanon from the 33-yard line, looks like. Reese back to pass. Throw it deep down the right side. He overthrows his man. They finally threw a flag at him. Holding. Finally threw a flag on that. Number 13 is Toby Baker, or Eli Cook, rather, that he was intended for. And he was held by the defensive back. That'll be.
That's a 15-yard penalty. That'll be a first down for the Pioneers.
They're going to mark it on the Pioneer 48-yard line. It'll be first and 10, Pioneers from the left hash. Honaker leads this 14-0. Two quick scores, the first two possessions they had, one after a Lebanon fumble. There's been no punts in the game yet, Jamie. Reese in the backfield with, I can't tell who that is. That's not Dylan back there now. Reese takes a snap, drops back to pass. Pressure runs out of there and gets free down the left sideline and scampers out of bounds. Scampers out of bounds at about the Honaker 46-yard line and gets knocked down over there, but no flag.
Well, yeah, that should have been a flag. He stepped out of bounds.
He's stepping out of bounds, and they hit him late.
He was well out of bounds, but no flag. Looks like he's going to pick up about 6 yards on that carry. It's going to be second down, and I don't know, give him five on the carry.
Be second and five. Yeah, wide outs coming to the right, two wide outs to the right.
I tell you, Reese athletic, he'll be hard to catch back there. He's got good speed, he's pretty quick.
Lebanon had a little trouble lining up, now they're ready. Reese takes the snap, drops straight back, looks over the middle, throws it short, and incomplete. So a flag?
I don't see a flag.
I think it was intended for Toby Baker, but couldn't come up with it.
Oh, yeah, I see the flag over there now. They're going to mark that one off against Honaker.
See what that call is. Holding. Defensive holding by Honaker. So that's going to bring the ball deeper into Honaker territory at the Honaker 32-yard line. It'll be first and 10 Pioneers. Baker is one of the leading receivers that Reese likes to go to.
Well, he can catch them. He's a good receiver.
He's on the right side in on the inside position. Now, here's a flag thrown. Honaker come running up to fake a rush, and Pioneers must have moved, and they're calling illegal procedure on Lebanon, so they'll move it back 5 yards.
Yeah, one of the defensive backs came charging up, and I guess Pioneer lineman
caused the lineman to move, I think.
Caused a movement there.
So it'll be first down and about 14 from the...
Should be first and 15.
15 from the 42. Honaker's 42. Reese back to pass, fakes one out, throws it deep down the sideline, and a battle for it, and it's knocked away, and Honaker may have caught that.
Well, he intercepted it, number four.
I can't see through this glass here with this sun hitting us. Looks like two Tigers were there. It's an ill-thrown pass by Reese. He lobbed that one up there and right into coverage.
So Honaker has it on their own 23-yard line. It'll be first and 10.
Reese looked like he might have got shaken up a little bit on that play after he threw it.
Yeah, he got hit pretty good there.
He's coming off, slowly coming off of the field. So Honaker's got it first and 10 from their own 23-yard line?
23, yeah. It's on the 23.
Got 8 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first period. Honaker leads at 14-0. Peyton Music back to pass. Now he's getting pressured. Runs out of there and throws it on the run. And it's incomplete. Broken up over on the sideline. I believe that's... We don't have any numbers right, evidently, on there. That was Riley, I think. They said it broke that up, Jamie, but we don't have a Riley, do we? Looks like number seven. I've got Seth Smith as number seven. So Honaker will have it second down and 10. Number 23. Music in the backfield by himself. Takes a snap, that's low, takes a snap, runs out of there, breaks a tackle, and scoots all the way down to the 15 inside Pioneer territory before he's knocked out of bounds. Lowe's a really good running back, and he squirted through there, broke a couple tackles at the point of attack, and then was gone.
Picked up 34 yards on that carry, Merle.
I'm not sure who knocked him out. I think it might have been Jordan Johnson.
I tell you what, he's got good speed. He's shifty, hard to bring down.
He's strong, too.
He's back there.
He's back in the shotgun by himself. I don't think Music's out there on the field, is he? Lowe takes a snap, runs off right tackle. Big hole there. Finally, he's grabbed and wrestled down at about the first down marker, about the 32. See if they give him a first down.
I think they... Saying it's a little bit short, picks up 9 yards on that carry down to about the 37-yard line where it'd be first and 10.
It's about the 32, Jamie.
32, sorry. Yeah. It is a first down, so give him 10 yards on the carry.
Now Honaker's got Jackson Dye in the backfield there with Music. Music's back in there quarterback. The music can run too out of there. He's good size. He hands it to Dye. Dye got to get run into his own man in the backfield and then finally squirted ahead to the 30.
Picked up a couple yards there, maybe three.
They're going to give him three down to the 29-yard line.
Second down and seven for the Tigers. 7:01 left here first quarter. Honaker leads it 14-0, and they're driving once again. Pioneers moved the ball last time they had it, but the interception caused
Dye back on the backfield. Dye in the backfield with Music. Music takes a snap, throws it out in the flat. The flag flies as Parker Bandy with the catch. And I thought I saw him throw a flag. I did see a flag on the field. A flag at the point of the tackle where Bandy was tackled at about the 25-yard line. Got the ball resting just outside the 25. Holding called against Honaker.
I think the Pioneers refused that penalty. No, they're going to take it.
Yeah, they're going to take the penalty. That's what the referee was doing, asking the Pioneers if they wanted to take that penalty. That moves it all the way back to the Pioneers' 36-yard line.
That's a 10-yard penalty.
So it'll be second and about 14. Pioneer secondary should be alert now. You know Mandy's going to try to get that yardage back. Or Music, rather. Dye goes in motion. Lowe goes in motion. They throw it out to him in the flat, and he can't handle the pass. It's incomplete.
That was not a good throw there.
Toby Baker on the coverage.
That'll get your receiver killed there, Merle, throwing a pass like that.
That's right. He had to try to jump up and get that, and he's bearing down.
Yeah, he was wide open, and the Pioneer defender chose not to hit him. So he's throwing about 15.
He'd have caught that. He'd been dead meat. Pioneer moved again. Honaker backing off of the ball. Now they're set again. Snap back to him. Handoff to Dye. And Dye runs it down close to the 30, about the 31. He's upended.
Picks up about six on the play. It's going to be fourth down and nine. Honaker in four down territory, though, for sure.
These numbers on our roster are all wrong, Jamie. I can't get to Lebanon numbers. The tackles made.
Well, I've got the roster, but I can't find it.
Fourth and nine. Back to pass again. Music throws it over the middle, and it's complete. Parker Bandy, and he's got just enough for the first down.
Yeah, took it just inside the 20-yard line at the 19, and he made a nice catch there.
Yes, he did.
I thought that ball was going to come out, but he managed to hold on to it.
Good throw and a good read by quarterback Music. He looked around quite a bit before he found that receiver, and it was Bandy, probably his favorite receiver. Lowe and Dye both in the backfield now, flanking on either side of Music. Music takes a snap, hands it to Dye going to the left, and he's hit at the line of scrimmage, keeps fighting. And doesn't get much on it, might give him a couple of yards.
Got two more than he should have, though. Pioneers hit him right there at the line of scrimmage, but couldn't bring him down.
Ball's marked at the 17-yard line. Ball's on about the 18-yard line. Lowe goes in motion to the right. Music throws it deep, got a man in the end zone. Can't handle it, overthrown just a bit. Pass was intended for Bandy again. But he overthrew him in the end zone, had him open, but Pioneer defender was trailing him pretty close. He overthrew it. Third and eight again from the 18-yard line. ball's on the left hash now. I don't understand why it's on the left hash. It wasn't there before that play. It was over in the middle. I don't know why they moved it to the left hash. Maybe Honaker has the right to do that. Three wide outs to the right now. Music runs out of there, and a flag flies, and Lebanon players just kind of quit when the flag flew, and Music took it all the way down to about the 10-yard line. I think there's a holding call on the Honaker, I believe. We'll wait and see the signal, but preliminary signal is holding. Pioneers will accept that penalty. They'll have to accept that because Music took that ball all the way down to about the 10. The Pioneer defenders just quit when they saw that flag. That's going to bring the ball back to about the 27-yard line. Mark it to 28, actually. So it'll be third and 18. Pioneer's not getting much pressure on Music at all, are they? He's run out of there a time or two, but there wasn't a whole lot of pressure. He got loose when he ran out. Now here's a flag. Flag flies previous to the snap, and I think he called Lebanon for offsides. Now that's illegal procedure on Honaker. We'll move it back five more. That'll move it back to the 38-yard line. Now they must have refused that penalty, Jamie. Why would they refuse that?
No, I don't think they refused it. I think they penalized them 5 yards.
Ball's at the 33-yard line. Now, Music throwing deep down into the right corner. End zone. It looked like it was caught down there. Receiver was right, defender was right there.
That was number three. He caught that one, I think.
That was Avery Music with the reception. Good catch. Defender was right there with him, and pretty good throw by Music to get it to him. So Honaker goes up 20 to nothing here with 3:56 left in the first quarter. And Honaker will try to get a two-point conversion.
That was 33 yards, wasn't it?
Yep.
Who caught the ball now?
Avery Music, I think. Low in the backfield by himself. He takes a snap, runs off right tackle. He gets stacked up there, but he made it into the end zone barely. So the two-point conversion is good. Honaker leads 22-0 with 3:56 to go in the first. We'll be back in a moment. You're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ. Touchdown again was...
That's Braden Marsh is kicking there for Honaker.
He approaches the ball, puts a foot in it. Pretty good kick down to the 15-yard line, which is taken and run back up to the 30-yard line by number four, Jamie. There's number four running that back. You got
Long, I think is who it was.
Long. So the Pioneers will have it first and 10 from their own 30. It's Long brought it out to the 30-yard line. Looks like Honaker's defense is kind of doubling up on these, one of these outside receivers. Reese wants to throw it, being pressured. Now he's hit and dropped back at the 20-yard line. It's going to be a pretty big loss, about a 10-yard loss.
Lose about nine.
Nine, they're going to make it nine. It's at the 21-yard line. So it'll be second and 19 for the Pioneers from their own, from their own 19-yard line. It's actually 21-yard line. Reese to throw. He's got a man knocked away trying to hit Toby Baker.
threw that in behind him a little bit there.
Yes, he did. I can't see the Honaker numbers very well. They don't show up very well. Like number 34 that broke that up. These things aren't worth a hoot, these rosters I had. It's third and 19 now after the incompletion. Reese back to pass, runs out of there to his right, motion for the man to go downfield. He runs out of bounds up about the 25-yard line. Couldn't get a man open down the right side, and he didn't have a throw back into the middle anywhere.
We'll pick up back two.
It'll be fourth down. Looks like Toby Baker will do the kicking, Jamie. I don't know how they, I guess the offensive team has the right to choose which hash mark you put it on for certain plays. They're moving it around some. Didn't realize they could do that. Referee's stopping something for some reason. Now they put the ball down on the 23, where it'll be snapped from there. Baker back to kick. Back deep for Honaker is low, I believe. He's standing back at about his own 40. Baker gets a kickoff towards the sidelines, and it goes out of bounds at about the 48-yard line of Lebanon. They're going to say the 49-yard line. First and 10, Honaker from the Lebanon 49. Honaker leads 22-0 here in the first quarter, with 2:52 remaining in the first. Pioneers have been unable to get any kind of offense going. One of them stopped by a fumble.
Good field position once again for the Tigers.
Pioneers hadn't had field position at all.
Honaker leads it 22-0. Moving the ball pretty much at will, Merle.
It's like Lowe's out in the slot with Avery Music wide out to this near side. Lowe goes in motion, gets the pitch from the quarterback, and runs through a couple of tackles and goes all the way down to the Pioneer 36-yard line, looks like.
Pick up about 14 yards on that carry.
That'll be first and down, first and 10, Honaker.
I tell you, he runs hard and he's quick too.
Yeah, he gets to the hole quickly. Pioneers are not filling those holes very well. Tigers must be doing a good job blocking as part of it. Reese down here on the sideline with a headset on, talking to somebody upstairs. He and Baker are there conferring, trying to get together on what to do. Hand off to Lowe. He going to the right side again. Cuts back inside and three flags fly. I think he probably got Honaker holding again. We'll wait and see. Honaker's walking back.
Yeah, we'll count that one. That'll cost them 10.
Holding Honaker is the signal. That'll bring the ball back to the Lebanon 46-yard line. It'll be first and a bunch.
First and 20, I'd say.
First and a little more than that, looks like. Should be close to 20.
I think it's 20 right on the button.
Music in the shotgun, steps back to pass, throws it quick out to the right side, and dodging one tackler is Bandy, and finally brought down. Before he can get much farther upfield at about the 41-yard line.
Picks up five on that one, so that should make it second down and 15.
It's hard to see the Lebanon numbers too, Jamie, the way they put these uniforms together anymore.
I think it's just our eyesight.
That may be part of it. Second and 15 from the 41. Music back to pass again. Now he's going to run out of there. He gets to the sideline and goes out of bounds after picking up about 3 or 4 yards. He's going to mark it at the Pioneer 38-yard line. We'll be third down at about 12.
Minute 24 left here in the first quarter. Honaker leads it 22-0.
They need to take it to the 25-yard line. Ball's on the 38.
They got three wideouts this way.
Back to pass. He's looking for Music. Now he runs out of there and throws it on the sideline. Had a man open over Bandy and he dropped it. Incomplete.
Yeah, he was over there pretty close to the first down spot and unable to catch that one.
So it'll be fourth down and 12.
I think he was trying to keep from going out of bounds. Looks like Honaker's going to go here.
They'll go for it, I'm sure. Pioneers need to bow up here. They've kind of stymied Honaker with the help of some penalties here on this drive. Honaker spread out all over the field now. Music back to pass, throws it over the middle, and it's incomplete. Pass was intended for number 12, I think, or number, it wasn't 12. Maybe it was 12, that might have been Lowe that they were throwing to. He couldn't hang on to it.
So Pioneers will get the ball first and 10. Just shy of the 40-yard line, about the 37-yard line. They're on 37.
See if Lebanon can get something going here now.
They've got three wideouts to the right. Man in the slot on the left. Actually, there's a slot man on the right here, too.
Reese throws it quick over the middle, and it's batted down. Batted down there right in front of him. One of the defensive linemen got a hand up and knocked it down, so it'll be second and 10. Johnson was the one that got a hand on it.
Pioneers only completed one pass, Merle, and that was about a 31-yard gain followed by a fumble.
He sends his halfback in motion. Now he's going to be tackled in the backfield. The ball came loose, but it was after he hit the ground. No fumble.
Lost a lot of yards there. Probably about 12 yards.
Reese coming over, making some kind of sign at the sideline. He's not too happy with what's going on.
So it's going to be third down and about 20 anyway.
He's got wideouts again to the right. It's Baker, the one farthest out. I think it's 13. Who's 13, Jamie? Can you tell? You still got your roster?
Yeah, I'll look at it here in a minute.
Reese back to pass, gets pressured again and gets away. And now throws it on the run, looking for the receiver out at the 45-yard line, looking for Baker, and Baker couldn't corral it. It was going out of bounds, a little bit overthrown towards the sidelines. And Baker tried to stay in and catch it, couldn't come down with it.
Aiden Stiltner's number 12, Merle.
Okay. He was one involved in that last play before that one. Now Baker will go back and punt again. Low back deep, standing at his own 40-yard line. Lebanon getting a lineman out there late. I don't think they have a play clock operating here tonight.
No, they're not. They couldn't get the one down on the east end to come on.
Baker gets kick. Good high sprawling kick. Taking it about the 43-yard line by Lowe, and he runs it back into Lebanon territory all the way down inside the 40 to about the, move on marker to 35, actually.
That was a pretty good putt there. Prime Miners didn't get much coverage on it.
No, they didn't. He got it up high.
All right, that's the end of the first quarter. Honaker leads it 22-0. Back with second quarter action. You're listening to high school football on WLRV it again.
107.3 WXLZ.
I believe we'll be all right after this one.
Can you tell who's it was, injured us?
54.
All right, we're back here ready for the Honaker kickoff. Trying to see who that injury was.
That's Robert Stevenson, I think.
I believe you're right.
He's a little gimpy there, but probably it may not be a major injury. I don't know. They're looking at his knee, though. I hope not, because he's a pretty good football player.
Yes, he is.
One of them's Dalton Long.
Braden Marsh will kick for Honaker, and he puts a foot into it straight downfield, end over end. Long has it at the 16-yard line, runs it back to the 20, and the ball comes loose again, and Honaker recovers it. I'm not sure if it came loose before he hit the ground or not, Jamie.
They're going to call it a turnover.
They're calling it a fumble.
Third fumble for the Pioneers. They lost two of them. That puts Honaker at the Pioneer 31-yard line.
Puts Honaker in real good position after that fumble. The Pioneer body language is not too good among the players, Jamie, there. Moping around a little bit.
Well, when you give up 30 points in a quarter and a half, it does something to your body language.
I guess it does, but they need to bow up, and I'm sure they're trying. It's dying in the backfield now with Music. Three wide outs to the left, one to the right. One to the right is Bandy. Music takes a snap, runs it up the middle, and it's knocked out of bounds somewhere near the 27-yard line.
Yeah, they're going to mark him on a 27. Give him a gain of four there. I think it'll be second down and six. We've got 9:33 left here in the first half.
Pioneers really hadn't met.
Honaker leads it 30-0.
Pioneers really hadn't been able to put anything together on offense. I think Reese has had trouble finding enough room to throw. Honaker defense is getting after him.
That was one thing I was really worried about, if he's had time. Now, you got to have time to throw that ball.
Music chased out of the pocket, throws it on the run. It's caught by Bandy near the sideline, inside the 10-yard line. He gets it down to about the 7 or 8.
I'll tell you, that was a big-time pass there. He was on the run, and Bandy had pulled up down about the 7-yard line, and he hit him.
Jeremy Bandy is really good at getting himself open, sitting down in an open area and making a good target for the quarterback. He's really good at that.
They mark it at the 8. It'll be first and goal.
Bandy's out wide to the right again. We got a slot man. That's Lowe. Lowe runs out of that slot out the left wing, and Music runs out of the pocket, throws it in the end zone to Bandy, I believe. Complete for a touchdown. Was that Bandy? I can't.
Number seven.
Seven. I just assumed it was Bandy. I believe it was Bandy.
You may be right. It was number.
It was number four. Yeah, I see him going off for now. It was number four. It was Bandy.
Okay.
Another injury. Pioneer injury. Time the Honaker will come back after the injury. We'll just stay here for this. Honaker will try the extra point as soon as we attend to the injured Lebanon player. We've got 8:57 left in the second period. Honaker leads this one 36-0 and threatening to get two more here on the extra point try. Can't tell who the Lebanon player is now, but they're getting him up now. Setting him up anyway. Usually some of the physical therapy group from Lebanon Physical Therapy are out here helping attend to these injuries.
They're probably here.
I'm sure that's some of them out there now. I He's still not getting, they set him up, but Spellon not trying to get him to his feet yet.
We've got 8:57 left here in the first half. 36 to nothing. Honaker leads it, and they've got an extra point try coming up.
Now they're going to get him up, and let's see if we can tell who it is, Jamie. It's nice. Is it 14?
Jordan Johnson.
Is that Johnson?
That's what the thing says.
Jordan Johnson. And he's coming off real gingerly with help.
Yeah, they're kind of helping him off there. Have no idea what happened to him.
He's not holding one foot up off of the ground as they help him. He's walking with both feet to the ground, but I don't guess that means a lot. Still could be a knee, but he's banged up a little bit. Darrell Taylor out there checking on him, and Coach Taylor comes back to the Lebanon sideline. Coach Taylor's really got the Honaker team going here early in the season. They're real explosive offensively. Bandy and Lowe are especially good at getting open. They're Music's favorite targets. I'm going to have the extra point try, and instead of Lowe running out of the Wildcat, Bandy's going to be out there.
Coach, you meant to say Coach Taylor there at Honaker.
Coach Taylor, yes. I say.
You said Taylor. Taylor and Taylor are pretty close together.
Yeah, I met Coach Taylor. Music back to pass, throws it out in the flat, and I don't think he got in there.
No,
good catch and a good tackle by the Pioneers there. I think, was that Lowe? I see him really low.
I don't know who caught it, but the Pioneers nailed him right on the spot, so. 36-0 with 8:57 to go here in the first half. And Honaker will kick off again.
I believe that was Braden Keene that caught that pass. I think that's who it was. I think it was 34.
Okay, you're probably right.
I tried to watch him as he went off, and he never would present his number to me. Kept going sideways. Marshall kickoff for Honaker. Back deep for Lebanon. Looks like they got different people back there now. I can't tell who's on your side, Jamie.
I can't see the number. I think it's Long, though, who I think it is.
Marsh set to kick it. And he does, and kicks it kind of short, about to 20. Need to get on it, and finally picked up by Long and tackled immediately. They almost let Honaker get to that ball before he picked it up.
Yeah, that kickoff's live if it hits the ground. So the Pioneers will have it at their own 24-yard line, first and 10, and they desperately need to move the ball.
Thought maybe Honaker was going to be substituting some on defense, but I don't believe they are. Most of these guys for Honaker are playing both ways. Bandy is a deep safety. Aiden Lowe's playing like an outside linebacker or defensive back.
I think Baker's our quarterback now. No, it's Reese, I'm sorry.
That's still Reese. Straight back to pass. Now he runs out of there, gets away from one man, and finally run out of bounds after a short game.
He lost a little
lost
about a yard.
It's going to move it back to about the 13, isn't it?
No, it's 23.
23, I mean, yeah.
So it'll be second down and 11.
Reese back to pass again. Fakes a pass, runs it up the middle, breaks one tackle, and goes down at about the 25-yard line. Not much gain there.
That was a good tackle there by number 71. He didn't get food. That was Tyler Cole.
Good
quarterback draw, I think, and he stayed home.
Honaker defenders up front, maybe it's the linebackers, but they're pretty quick. They're not getting fooled by much. Here's Reese to pass again, throws it, and it's tipped away. Tipped away by number six. They don't have a six on the roster. Maybe it's number five. Is that five or six? That's a six in it, Jamie. I think it was intended for Sifford. Or I'm looking at the wrong lineup. It was intended for, well, I can't see the number there. May have been Dillon. I'm not sure. Number nine going out there is Dunford. He sits up in the, on the wing. And Baker boots it again. It's high and short and bounces, gets a good Lebanon bounce. And Honaker's going to let it go. And bounce down to about the 35-yard line. We'll see where they mark it in a moment, but Pioneer's unable to move the ball, had to punt it out of there. Baker's done a pretty good job punting, Jamie.
Yeah, his last two punts have been pretty good. That was good for a lot of yardage.
Still haven't marked it down.
Well, they called an illegal procedure on the Pioneers, but Honaker refused it. So the ball's back on the Honaker 33-yard line. He got pretty good yardage on that punt.
Got 8 minutes remaining in the first half. Honaker leads it 36 to nothing. Lebanon unable to get any kind of offense going against the Honaker defense. Honaker's pretty big up front. Those boys are not slow. They move pretty good, and they're putting a lot of pressure on Mike Reese.
Well, they got a lot of kids coming back off that team last year, Merle.
Yeah, they did. Lebanon's pretty young.
I figured Honaker, I'm a little surprised at how easy it's been for him so far, but
Lowe goes in motion. He gets the handoff going to the left. So the jet sweep, and he dodges tacklers and gets to the 50, 45, and Lebanon can't catch him. Finally wrestled him down at about the inside the 15-yard line of the Pioneers. Big run to Lowe's. He dodged tacklers down the field, picked up a couple of good blocks.
Picked up about 44 yards, I think, Burrow.
He's a really good running back.
Well, he's fast enough, and he's pretty strong, too.
Yes, he is. Nice Honaker. I wouldn't worry about throwing it as much as they do with him. Him and Dine, the line they've got. We got a timeout.
Honaker called it.
We'll break away for these messages. You're listening to High School Football and 107.3 WXLZ.
47 remaining. It's first and 10 for Honaker. That's Dye, I think.
Jackson Dye with
picks
the carry.
Up a couple. Councilwood and Honaker play next week up at Honaker. We'll have that game here on WXLZ.
Another official timeout for injury. Another Lebanon player down. They can't afford to lose too many players, Jamie.
No, you really can't. That might be a cramp there, as hot as it is. That's sometimes a problem early, too. All right, we'll take a break. Be back. You're listening to High School Football on WXLZ.
Number 60.
All right, give it back to me.
All right, we're back. Honaker with the ball. The snap goes over Music's head. He's retreating all the way back to the 40, being chased by the Pioneers, and a throw is incomplete near the sideline. Intended for Bandy. He tried to get back and give Music a target to throw to, but he could, Music under too much pressure and threw it away.
Well, the snap was real high. It went over Music's head.
He did a good
Pioneers
job.
Couldn't catch him. He did a good job evading a tackler and threw it and nearly completed it.
36-0 Honaker lead. 7-17 to go.
It'll be third and eight for the Tigers. They're, once again, they're in four down territory.
Jackson Dye back there with Music. Music throws it out to the right, and it's caught. And having trouble knocking him down, but to finally get him down, that's... Who was that? What was that number, Jamie?
It was 80-something, 84, I think.
It's Brock. That's looking at Lebanon. There's not an 84 on the roster.
Right now, Max
might have been Malachi Lowe.
It was Lowe.
Honaker huddling up for the one of the few times they've huddled tonight. It's 4th and 7. Ball right on the 15-yard line. Died back in the backfield with Music, and whistle stopped the play.
Too much time.
Delay of game by Honaker.
Play clocks are not working, so that bank judge has a stopwatch, and he gives a signal when they get inside, I think, 5 seconds.
Yeah, that's the way they do that when they don't have a shot clock going.
So that's another 5-yard penalty. Honaker gotten penalized a lot here tonight.
I think they've been penalized more than Lebanon, haven't they? 4th down and 12 now from the 20. High snap. Music gets up there. Throws it over the middle. Got a man open. That's Parker Bandy, and he's got it at the 5-yard line. And that'll be enough for a first down. He's some kind of good receiver, Jamie.
Yeah, he gets open. Peyton Music throws that ball pretty well, too. He's got a good arm.
He does. First and 10 Tigers. First and goal, actually. 1st and 4. They're on the 4-yard line. Dies the back there with Music. Music retreats and then runs it out to the right and makes it into the end zone. Tackled as he went across the goal line. And Honaker strikes again. So another flag. Holding on Honaker.
Oh, okay.
That'll take that touchdown away.
Another 10-yard penalty.
Honaker takes another timeout, so we'll break away again. You're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ. Leading at 36-0. Threatening to get more. It's first down now, but it's 1st and 14 after the holding penalty. So the ball is marked back to the, I guess that's the 14-yard line,
yeah.
So they got a 1st and goal, actually, is what it amounts to. Nye goes in motion out to the left. And Music runs out of there to the right and finally throws it. Intended for Bandy, that was intended for Lowe, maybe. I think that was intended for Lowe, incomplete at the goal line.
Nice knocked away. By Luke Monk, number 55. He got a hand on it, sir.
Second down and goal from the 14. Bandy's out wide to the right. Dye's in the slot, and Lowe's back up running back with Music. High snap. Fake it to Lowe, and Music runs out to the right and gets knocked out of bounds at about the 7-yard line, and a flag flies at the end of the play. Another Honaker penalty.
Yeah, I think called a block in the back or.
It is an illegal block. Yeah. block in the back by Honaker. And that'll move it back again. I guess that must have been at the end of the play. They must have given them a play and then marked it back to him. Because it's at about the 18, isn't it, or 17?
Yeah.
Snap back to Music. Looks to his left, then runs out of there to the left. And he takes it all the way into the end zone over on the far sideline. Looks like he got a block over there. Couldn't tell if it was illegal or not. Evidently not. They didn't call it. Music had a free run down the sideline over there. Pioneers just didn't get out there. They're just not covering sideline to sideline very well. Music's having his way running the ball. It's 42 to nothing now as we near halftime. 6:12 to go in the period. And Lowe's going to run out of the Wildcat. And he runs off right tackle and scampers into the end zone pretty easily that time for the two-point conversion. Our score, Honaker 44, Lebanon nothing. You're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ. Go ahead and give us 1 minute.
They sure start running that clock now, too.
Yeah.
What happened there that he was fast.
He just dropped it, I think. This is Luke Garrett out here wide to the left. Now there's a pitch to the running back, Dylan. He cuts back inside and takes it across midfield before he's knocked down. That looked like Lowe. I wasn't sure if that was Lowe on the tackle or if that was 19. I believe it was Lowe, and he went hobbling off, shaking up a little bit. Third and seven now for the Pioneers from the Honaker 48. It's about as far as they've been, Jamie, I think. Back to pass, throws it over the middle and got it. Caught at the 40-yard line near first down yardage. See who caught that. To Baker again. That was Baker on the reception. Made a good catch there. First and 10. Quick throw out to. I think that was Baker again. No, that was it.
Tried to hit a little quickie. That one got away from him.
That was intended for Knuckles, and Knuckles stopped. I think Reese thought he was going to go run on into the middle a little bit.
Incomplete pass. It'll be second and 10.
Reese back to pass again. Pressured out of there. He's going to drop for a loss way back at the Lebanon 45.
We'll lose about 15 on that one, looks like.
He's not getting much help and much protection, Jamie. He didn't have a chance to run out of there.
Like I said earlier, that was a concern of mine before the season, is we could, I don't care how good you thought, you got to have a little time to set up and throw.
It's third and 22 now for Lebanon from the 48.
He had no time at all that time.
Now he sets up a screen, but Hunter was looking for that, and the tackle made quickly. I don't know who that was intended for.
Didn't gain anything. It was caught, but no gain. And Honaker takes another timeout. I don't know why, but...
I think that was Dustin Rose on the reception.
We got 48 seconds left here in the first half. 44-0, Honaker leads it. And the Pioneers in a punting situation.
Don't have much choice, do they?
Yeah, I'm not sure I wouldn't run a fake punt. I'm serious.
Yeah, it wouldn't hurt anything. I mean, what could it hurt? Baker's pretty elusive. He might get the first down. Honaker's just showing a lot of quickness along the front and the linebackers, and Lebanon's unable to get anything going. Seconds to go now. Baker back to punt. Aiden Lowe back deep for Honaker. I believe he's back in there. We'll check the number in a moment. Taking a lot of time here before the kick. Of course, the clock's not running. Snap to Baker. It's good. The kick is high. It's kind of short. Coming up to get it is Aiden Lowe. And he runs right by a couple of Lebanon defenders and gets to the sideline. Down the sideline he goes, and he's going to take it all the way to the house, I believe, Jamie. Aiden Lowe with a good run back.
I don't know where he caught it. Probably about the 30-yard line.
Yeah, it was somewhere around his 25 or 30. I'd say it was right at the 30. Touchdown, Honaker. 50-0. Still in the first half. 30 seconds to go in the first half. Honaker for the extra point. Music in the shotgun. Die back there with him. He wants to throw it. Getting pressured, runs out of there now, and builds his way into the end zone for the extra point. Extra point's good. Our score at halftime or near halftime with 30 seconds left. 30 seconds left in the first half. 52-0. Honaker over Lebanon. We'll be back with the kickoff in a moment. You're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ. Getting tired, Jamie.
He's kicked them a lot, yeah.
Dalton Long back there deep. One of the up men is going to be Brock Keene, who's a youngster that just started playing this year, I think. Long is deep, and I can't see who the other one is on the other side is deep. They're kicking it towards Long. He comes up, gets it on the run at the 20-yard line and stumbles and goes down at about the 32.
Yeah, he got tripped up there. The grass got him at that. Yeah. Pretty good run back. He's got it out there about the...
Pioneers have 27 seconds to try to move it down there and get a shot at a field goal or a touchdown. Honaker will be back playing prevent, I'm sure, pretty deep. Reese in the shotgun. Now we're ready to go. Two wideouts on each side. And a whistle stops play. That's...
Reese took a snap and just took a knee.
Oh, he took a snap and took a knee. And that's going to let the clock run out. And that'll do it. Halftime score, Honaker 52, Lebanon nothing. Big blowout by Honaker here in the first half. We'll be back with halftime comments and run through the scoring for you. In a moment, you're listening to High School Football on 107.3 WXLZ.
3 minutes, Madison.
Marley Bush, pros. Macy Ferguson, humorous dramatic interpretation. Cecilia Gates, original oratory. Kendra Warren, state runner up series duo. Cheyenne Ball, state runner up series duo. Maddie Huffman, state runner up storytelling. Brianna Watts, state runner up series dramatic interpretation. Molly Bowman, state runner up humorous interpretation. Landon Owens, state runner up extemporaneous speaking. Emma Martin, state champion prose. Caitlin Mullins, state champion poetry. Chloe Dillon, state champion serious dramatic interpretation. Gracie Ford, state champion humorous duo. Madison Robinette, state champion humorous duo.
So does the offense or the defense?
Katie Cole, state champion storytelling. Connor Dillon, state champion serious duo. And Ellen Saunders, state champion serious duo. And finally, we'd like to recognize our amazing British coach, Miss Sarah Suits.
Well, they don't turn towards us usually. They're usually looking upfield. We're looking at them from the side, so it's hard to pick up the numbers sometimes. Here's Marsh's kickoff, and it's short. It's going to be taken at about the 28-yard line. Dillon with the return.
They don't really have a lot of kids dressed, Merle.
No, they don't. They really don't.
He may be kind of stuck with what he's got there.
Dalton Long's a little slow getting out there and getting set. And the offense, he goes out wide. The handoff's to Dillon inside. He pops across for about 2 or 3 yards. It's hard to penetrate that line with Honaker. They're not only pretty good size, Jamie, but they're pretty fast. They play, loose back to pass, throws it out, and swing pass to Dillon. He's going to lose a yard.
That was a good defensive play there. They might have got him for a face mask. I don't know.
Malachi Lowe with the tackle. And that is a face mask penalty against Honaker. You give Lebanon the first down in the Honaker turf. Reese back to pass again. throws it incomplete out to the sideline.
Didn't make a good pass that time, Earl. He never did get his back foot set.
Handoff's inside to Dillon, and he crashes ahead across the 35. Might mark it right at the 30. Now they're going to mark it at the 34, looks like. No, right on the 35. They put it right back on the 35.
He burst through there pretty good. Picked up about six.
Reese looks to the sideline. Now he's set for the play, gets the snap, rolls out to his right, gets pressured, and going to be dropped for a loss. Reese to pass, throws it deep for Garrett, and he couldn't haul it in.
He was open.
Yes, he did. He
had a step up the sideline and could have caught that one.
Just couldn't hang on. Snap is to Music. He throws it quickly out in the flat. And the Pioneers cover that one pretty well. He gets a little bit of yardage out of it.
Ernie Binko is on the camera. And we'll try to do some Russell County football here throughout the season.
I think it was Malachi Lowe on the reception. Honaker looks like they're, I don't know what they're doing. Looks like 88 would be Micaiah Lowe. Deep. Lebanon's got the ball, handed off inside to the running back. Second down play, hand off again, straight ahead to Dillon. He gets across the 45 to about
the, down for sure.
Sure does. Here's a handoff inside, he bounces outside, and Dillon takes it out to about the
that's a good effort.
He gets it down to about the 43-yard line. He handed it to him again straight ahead, and I believe he got enough for the first down.
Yeah, he got it down to the 40-yard line. That's more than enough.
First and 10 Pioneers from the Honaker 40. Quick throw. Got a man open. That's enough for the first down. He's going to scoot into the end zone. I believe that was Carter Dillon, wasn't it? Snap, kick, and the kick is good. Pioneers finally get on the board. He kicks it high and short to about the 27-yard line. It's taken by last play. He runs out to the right, throws it deep to the end zone, and oh, almost a good catch down there. And that is the ball game. Let's see who that player was.
Honaker got off to a fast start so early in the game. The Pioneers couldn't get any offense going. And, of course, Honaker scoring 52 points in the first half.